Usernames and passwords, the method of account security we've used for decades, is being challenged by a new standard of security known as passkeys. The security savior has arrived and the hackers have been defeated, right? Well, is this software version of identity verification secure? How does it work? And at the end of the day, are passkeys even worth using? The answer might surprise you because I know it did me. This explanation of passkeys is brought to you by YubiKey. There's a big reason I asked them to sponsor this video that I'll explain in a moment. The story of password protected accounts dates back to the 1960s when MIT researcher Fernando Corbato developed a password system to allow multiple people to use the same computer. It's crazy to think that what feels like such a common sense solution now was revolutionary back in those days. The process has been upgraded multiple times over the years to include password hashing, salting, and other security measures, but the basic concept has remained the same. It's what's known as a shared secret. In other words, the password you create for a login is shared by both you and the login provider. And for most of us, this is usually just a 10 to 20 character long password. When you log in, your password is matched against what they have in their database, and if they're the same, you're good to go. The problem with this method is that if this database gets hacked, the shared secret represents a security liability for us as users. And if you've been watching the news, these data breaches seem to be a daily occurrence. Up until recently, the primary way to solve for this liability is through what is known as two-factor authentication, or 2FA for short. If a password is something that you know, then the second factor should be an identifying characteristic of who you are, such as a fingerprint or face ID, or something that you have. This could be a code from a text message, an authenticator app, or my favorite, a physical 2FA security key like this one from YubiKey. The good news is that this is still a very good way to secure most of your accounts. And if you don't already have a 2FA security key, I recommend that you get one. So then what's the deal with passkeys? What are they and why do we need them? Passkeys are an attempt to improve the security and convenience of online logins. How do they do this? Well, unlike the shared secret of the username password method, passkeys utilize what is known as a public-private key pair, which is basically like separating the padlock and the key. These private keys are between 100 to 1400 bytes of random data, significantly longer than any password you've ever made. And the benefit of this is that, unlike the shared password, if the public key padlock is stolen, it's virtually impossible to mathematically reverse engineer the private key that unlocks it. And from a convenience standpoint, it promises to be amazing. I mean, since most passkeys are secured by biometrics like a fingerprint or your face scan, that means that in order to log in, I don't have to input a username, password, and 2FA code. All I have to do is verify biometrics. That's it, or at least in theory. But there's always this delicate balance between convenience and security. I mean, the standard behind passkeys has been around for years, but it's taken that long for major players like Google, Apple, and Microsoft to figure out how to present it to us, the public, in a way that we can understand, and more importantly, be motivated to start using. And the fact that you're watching this video is evidence that they still have a long way to go, am I right? Even with passkeys, there are security trade-offs that you can make depending on how you use them. And that all boils down to understanding the two different types of passkeys, syncable and single device. And this is incredibly important for you to understand because I think that a good personal security strategy should use both of them. A syncable passkey is one that can be copied and used on multiple devices. This is what you get when you create a passkey on an Apple device, an Android device, your internet browser, or even a third-party password manager like 1Password. The passkey is created and then synced between the multitude of devices that you have logged into that particular account. And in some cases, you can even share that passkey with other people. But no matter how you do it, you still have to prove your identity in order to use that passkey, whether that's biometrics like your face ID or via a master password. And in the end, it's really no different than using that sign in with Google or sign in with Apple credentials. The benefit of a syncable passkey is that it's not bound to a single device that can be lost. But the very fact that it can be copied introduces a bit of risk. And there's also something to be said about trusting Apple or Google with all of your passkeys, even though from what I've read, passkeys aren't trackable. Now, a single device passkey, on the other hand, is bound to one piece of hardware and it can't be copied to the cloud or even to another device. I'm going to use my YubiKey as an example here. With my key plugged into my computer, I'm going to open up the Yubico app, enter my key pin, which is required when you're using passkeys here. And then you can see all of the single device passkeys I've already created that reside only on this key, from Amazon to Google to LinkedIn. Now, obviously, the biggest problem here is that the loss of this key would be detrimental to me, which is why I simultaneously created another passkey on a different YubiKey that I store safely elsewhere. Another problem you see is how few passkeys I have. And I promise you, this isn't for lack of trying. The standard has been slow to be adopted, and in my experience, there are a lot of places, like Twitter, for example, where for some reason they only allow us to create syncable passkeys from a mobile device and nowhere else. It is really frustrating. Now, I've done a separate video showing you how to set up passkeys on your Google or Amazon accounts, but let's take a quick look at what the login process looks like and why I'm not over the moon excited about passkeys yet. Let's say I want to log into my Amazon account using my passkey that I've already created. The first thing I have to do is to click sign in, which brings me to a place where I have to input my email or phone number. That's odd because I thought a passkey was supposed to replace the username and password combo, but whatever. I'll put in my email and click continue. At this point, I can still use my password to log in, or I have the option to sign in with a passkey. Now, for a syncable passkey, let's say you stored your passkey in the iCloud or 1Password account, the next step is checking biometrics or your master password. For a single device passkey, which I have stored on my YubiKey, you can just click this second option, tap on the key, type in your PIN, tap on the key again, and then boom, now we, oh, wait, in both cases, I still have to enter the 2FA one-time passcode. Now I have to pull up my authenticator app, copy the code and paste it in this box, and finally I've been signed in. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, how is this any different or more convenient than using a password to log in? I 100% agree with you. For now, it seems that passkeys are not replacing the username, password, and 2FA combo like we've been promised. Instead, in most cases, it seems that it's just replacing the password. So if passkeys aren't offering any improvement on the process, at least, and if your regular password is still used as a backup, what's the point? Should you use passkeys? The answer is sure. I mean, it's definitely not a bad thing, but that's not the question you should be asking. The question you need to ask is how you should use passkeys. See, every company seems to implement this standard differently, and every person has their own security and convenience tolerance. So I want to share with you my recommendations. First, you don't have to use passkeys if you're using a physical security key for two-factor authentication. Now, if you aren't using a security key from Yubico, I highly recommend you get at least two of them, one as your primary and one or two as a backup. And I'm not just saying that because they're sponsoring this video. They really are the highest form of security for your accounts right now. And that's even considering passkeys, in my opinion. Using this kind of security key as two-factor authentication against the standard username password combo is becoming almost universal across the internet now. I mean, some websites still limit us to authenticator apps for 2FA, which is ridiculous. But by and large, I use my key on a daily basis for a multitude of logins. As for passkeys, honestly, they've been a bit frustrating for me to set up, and they aren't used on nearly as many accounts as I'd like. But as adoption grows, here's what I'm doing. First, syncable passkeys are an excellent option for what I would call non-sensitive logins. If you exclusively use Apple devices, then create your passkeys with the new Passwords app. If you exclusively use Android devices, then create them there. And if you need cross-platform access to your passkeys, that's where something like 1Password or other password managers work really well. The idea here is convenience for those accounts that aren't holding super sensitive personal data. For example, when I use passkeys to log into Adobe or Home Depot, I'm comfortable storing that as a syncable passkey, but with something like Coinbase or PayPal where finances are involved, I take a much more serious approach to security and prefer using a single device passkey that is backed up on another single device. To figure out which to use for which accounts, simply ask yourself, what kind of damage could somebody inflict on my reputation, my finances, or even my digital life if somebody had full access to this account? Retirement accounts are an obvious place to create a stronger login. Some social media accounts might fit into that category as well, whereas stuff like news sites, loyalty accounts, and even streaming services really don't matter as much. Listen, I wish I could tell you that usernames and passwords are going to be obsolete in the next few years, but sadly, I just don't think that's happening anytime soon. In the meantime, the best thing that you and I can do is to start or continue using strong two-factor authentication on every account that you can. These YubiKeys are ideal for that. And if you're willing, start trying out passkeys. Make sense? Well, if not, I'm gonna dive even deeper into passkeys in an upcoming live stream here on the channel, which you'll find right here. You're welcome to leave questions in the comments, but hopefully I'll be able to answer most of them in that live stream. You can also check out this recent video where I show you the step-by-step process for how I set up my passkey on Amazon.